This is part 3 of a series on artificial neural network. In this video, we will look at the gradient descent algorithm. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English. My voice was generated by AI, text-to-speech. In the last video, we looked at the prediction process of a neural network and looked at the objective function required for the training process. In this video, we will look at the gradient descent algorithm and look at how to find the approximate gradients using numerical differentiation. The parameters of this ANN, WH, BH, WO, and BO are determined through the training process. During the training process, parameters are adjusted to minimize the loss function. The loss function is calculated using the actual target value and the predicted value obtained through the prediction process. Mean squared error, binary cross entropy, or cross entropy can be used as a loss function for ANN model. Initially, parameters are initialized randomly. The parameters are then iteratively updated in the direction that the loss function becomes smaller. Gradient descent is a widely used method for updating parameters. As the parameters are updated, the loss function value becomes smaller, so the predicted values get closer to the actual target values. Now let's look at the gradient descent method through a simple example. Let's say the objective function looks like this. It is a function of W. Our goal is to find the minimum point of this loss function using gradient descent method by differentiating this equation with respect to W and finding the point where the slope is zero. It is easy to see that the optimal W is 2. This equation is easy to solve because it only has one variable. However, this method is difficult to solve when there are many variables. Deep learning today uses millions, tens of millions, or even more variables. In such cases, numerical analysis must be used to solve this problem. Let's solve this problem using gradient descent, the most widely used method in numerical analysis. Let's first look at the figure below. The loss function L looks like this. Initially set W to a random value. Then find the slope of L at that point. The slope at this point is like this. When the slope is negative, we know that the W we're looking for is on the right. If the initial value of W is at this point, the slope is positive. When the slope is positive, we know that the W we're looking for is on the left. So if the slope is negative, we increase W slightly. And if the slope is positive, we decrease W slightly. If we express this as a formula, it would look like this. If the slope is negative, WT plus 1 will be greater than WT. And if the slope is positive, WT plus 1 will be less than WT. WT is the current W value. T plus is the next W value. Here, alpha is a positive learning rate and a hyperparameter that determines how much W increases or decreases. By repeating this process, W will get closer to the optimal W we were looking for. This is the gradient descent method. Let me give you an example. Let's say the initial W value is 0.5. The slope at this point is negative 3. let the learning rate, alpha, be 0.25. Then WT plus 1 becomes 1.25. W gets closer to the optimal point. Loss L decreased from 2.25 to 0.56. At point WT plus 1, the slope is slightly flatter than before. So it moves less to the right than before. At the point where the slope is 0, this term becomes 0, so the next W is equal to the current W. That means it doesn't move anymore. By repeating this until W no longer changes, we can find the optimal W. Let's look at the case where there are two variables. Let's say that the loss function L looks like this. And let's say that the initial W is at this point. At this point, the gradients for each variable are as follows. Using these gradients, we can find the optimal point in a similar way to the left. Let's take an example. Let's say the loss function L looks like this. This is a function of W1 and W2. And the gradients with respect to W1 and W2 are as follows. Let the initial W1, W2 be 3, 2. At this point, the gradient with respect to W1 is positive 2. And the gradient with respect to W2 is negative 2. The next W1 is 3 minus 0.25 times 2, so it's 2.5. And the next W2 is 2 plus 0.25 times 2, so this is also 2.5. The initial W has moved this much towards the optimal point. And this figure shows that there are many different paths to reach the optimal point. So a path optimization process is required. We will look at this later in optimizer algorithms for neural networks. And the actual shape of L will be much more complex than this due to the many variables and nonlinear activation functions in the neural network. The actual shape of L will not be convex. Let's take a quick look at what the loss function L looks like in a neural network. Here's a simple neural network. There are 3 neurons in the input layer. There are 20 neurons in the hidden layer. And there is 1 neuron in the output layer. The activation function of the hidden layer is tanh. And the activation function of the output layer is sigmoid. Randomly generate 50 data points with 3 features. And generate 50 target Y data points for binary classification. WH, the connection between the input layer and the hidden layer, is a 3x20 matrix. Let's initialize them randomly. The connection between the hidden layer and the output layer, WO, is a 20x1 matrix. Let's randomly initialize them too. No biases are used. And we measure the mean squared error between the actual target Y values and the predicted Y hat values. We measure the mean square error by changing only connections W1 and W2, while keeping other connections fixed. Then visualize this. The results are as follows. This is a 3-dimensional representation of the changes in W1, W2, and loss. The shape of the loss appears non-convex and complex. In reality, the change in loss for all W will be represented in a high-dimensional space, and its shape will be much more complex. Gradient descent will try to find the point in this figure where the loss is minimal. However, there are several points where the loss is minimized locally. If the initial W is at this point, the W will move in this direction and eventually reach this point. If the initial W is at this point, the W will move in this direction and eventually reach this point. If this is the point where the loss is minimal, then this is the global minimum. In this case, it failed to find the global minimum and instead found a local minimum. This is a local minimum problem. We've discussed a lot about the local minimum problem in machine learning. This problem also exists in artificial neural networks. This problem cannot be fundamentally solved. However, ways to further improve this are continually being developed. We'll look at those later. Let's run this code. The results are as follows. Next, let's look at how to find the gradients. In the neural network below, the error and loss can be defined as follows. The desired output value from this neuron is y. And the actual output value from this neuron is y hat. Y are the values known from the data. Therefore, the error and loss can be easily defined like this. Automatic differentiation allows us to obtain the accurate gradients of the loss with respect to each parameter. We can use these gradients to adjust the weights and biases in the output layer using the gradient descent method. However, we cannot directly define the error and loss because we do not know what the desired output from this neuron is. So how do we adjust WH? The error in the output layer can be propagated to the hidden layers through the error backpropagation algorithm. Using the propagated error, we can find the gradients with respect to the parameters in the hidden layer. We can then use these gradients to adjust the weights and biases in the hidden layer using gradient descent method. The error backpropagation algorithm propagates backward the errors from the output layer to the hidden layers. We will look at this in more detail later. One way to find the approximate gradients is through numerical differentiation. Neural network can be trained roughly using numerical differentiation without using error backpropagation or automatic differentiation. Instead of finding the exact gradient, we find an approximate gradient and use gradient descent to adjust the parameters. When a function L is like this, the gradient at this point can be calculated approximately as follows. Here, H is a small number representing a small change in W. This is forward difference approximation method. Another method is the center difference approximation method. This method calculates the slope at this point this way. This method is slightly more accurate. In this series, we will use this method, and in later series, we will use automatic differentiation and error backpropagation algorithm. Lastly, let's use numerical differentiation to find the approximate gradient of the activation function. Define four activation functions as follows. And write a function to compute the gradient using numerical differentiation. We use the center difference approximation method. Create a variable x with values between -5 and +5. compute the gradients of the given function with respect to variable x. H is set to this value. Then we visualize the original function values and the computed gradient values. For the sigmoid function, the original function looks like this. The gradients with respect to the variable x look like this. If we differentiate the sigmoid function mathematically, we obtain this equation. The graph of the numerical differentiation is similar to that of the mathematical differentiation. The results of ReLU, Tanch, and Soft Plus functions are as follows. In this series covering the basics of ANNs, we will implement an ANN using this method. Let's run this code. The results of the sigmoid function are as follows. The results of the ReLU function are like this. And the results of the Tanch function are like this. The results of the soft plus function are like this. So far, we have looked at the gradient descent method and numerical differentiation method. In the next video, we will look at vanishing gradient, batch update, etc.